Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from GynaQ. And you ever go over to that Manage Gateways Connection page and you go, God, this thing has gotten out of hand. I need to do a better job at naming my connection strings and getting these things more organized. And it's so many reasons you need to do this from an administration, from a maintenance, and from a maintainability perspective. You really need to do this. But an even bigger reason would be from a usability perspective. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. If you switch over to this page, see, this is a very messy one, right? This page is very messy. I got all types of connection strings. They're not properly named. I have no idea what I'm doing. Now, through the magic of editing, I'm gonna switch over where I took some time this morning to clean this up. Let me show you. So now you can see I've prefixed all of my connection strings with some type of standard that goes with the connection type. So you can see ADLS Gen 2, Amazon S3, my blob, my Azure SQL, Cosmos. I probably should have put Azure Cosmos there. And if you want to, all you gotta do is go to settings. Most of the connections, if you're an owner, you can go and rename it. And so just like that, I've switched this one to Azure Cosmos, Azure SQL. Here's my files. Maybe thinking, Patrick, this is in chaos here. But I took about 20, 30 minutes to go and clean mine up. And now I have some organization. I was like, well, why do I need this organization? Before I show you why you need this organization, I want to show you how the chaos comes about. Where it usually happens is if someone goes here and let's go into a pipeline or data flow, wherever you would make a connection to a source. And so I'm just going to launch the copy data assistant. And what I'm going to do is say Azure SQL database. And then I'm going to provide a server name, database name, AdventureWorks. Retail, and you skip all this stuff and you choose organizational account and you click next. And so now it creates that connection string. And if you see right here, you can see, right, that's the name of it. And if I go over to this page and I click refresh, you'll see it creates a connection string with this name that pretty much has no meaning. How do I reuse this? And I'm going to show you what I mean by the usability and how it makes your life when creating pipelines and data flows and using Copilot for that fact. It makes your life so much simpler. All right, stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. I could rename this here, but I'm not. What I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this. I'm going to say remove this. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back, choose Azure SQL database again. Do this one more time. Windows.net. I need to take a typing class. AdventureWorks Retail. And then instead of just leaving this blank, I'm going to give it a name. Azure SQL, then the name of the server, then AdventureWorks Retail. Change my authentication, organizational account, and click next. Everything's set up. And then I come over here, I click refresh. It adds it for me, but the one thing that it does is it adds at the end my username. I don't like that. So one thing I'll do is come here and kind of clean that out. And I get why it does it, right? Because if somebody else creates the same connection, wants to add some uniqueness to it, but that's fine. And click save. And if that's part of your standard, if you want to do that where you are requiring people to include their username in the connection string, go for it, right? I'm not doing that in my case. I came up with my own standard. Now, let me show you why it's so important to do this. So I'm gonna go back over here and I'm gonna close this out, discard, yes. And then if I was using just the canvas and the graphical user interface to do most of this, if I type Azure, there's all my Azure connections right there, right? There's to my blob, there's to Cosmos, there's to SQL. If I type file, there's all the files that's available. If I type Amazon, there's my Amazon. You get the point. So now with that prefix, I just start typing that prefix and it lists out the connection strings I want. I don't have to guess. I don't have to type out the connection strings. It minimizes all that for me. But I have to show you this. If I wanted to just copy a table or a couple of tables quickly from one source, let's say into Fabric, I could use Copilot. Let me show you. So let's get out of this. You know, this is old school, right? So I'm gonna go Copilot. Now watch what I'm gonna type. Copy the dim promotion table from and then /, and then it lists all of my connections just by typing that little /. And so I'm gonna type Azure SQL because I wanna pull it from Azure SQL database. And then I'm gonna type into a new table in AdventureWorks, that's a lakehouse that I have in Fabric, into a new table named dim promotion. So then I click this. Give it a few seconds, boom, the activity is created. And so if I go here, click on the activity, you'll see the source is that source, right? That's the one I want to use. That's the table. And then if I go to destination, there you go, just like that. Do I want to run it? And I can choose run this pipeline. The usability that it creates when you start coming up with your own naming standard for these connection strings saves a lot of time and it removes a lot of guessing. All right, what do you think? Have you cleaned up your connections and gateway page? Have you used this approach? Are you deploying this out in your enterprise? You definitely should. I'd love to know what you think. You know what to do. Post some comments. Where? In the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric or all the other workloads like Power BI or data integration, there's probably a video flying above my head. Check it out. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.